December trip, and we're down at Iktus Lake, right down in the south of France, near the Pyrenees, southwest corner of France. And sun's just gone actually, it's been a lovely afternoon. But yes, it's quite pleasant. It's going to be quite cold soon. The nights have been quite cold, but days been okay so far. Not particularly good fishing weather, I would say that. I mean, it's lovely for us, you know, calm, flat surface, nice sunshine. So it's good for getting the rods out. I've got all the rods set up ready to go, so I'll do them in a minute. But we did it a different way this time. Because it was right down the southwest corner of France, what we did was got the ferry from Portsmouth down to Bilbao, top of Spain. And that meant only about a 2.5 hour drive up from Bilbao to the lake here. So that saved a lot of driving, instead of, I suppose, what would normally be, well, getting on for 1,000 miles, I suppose, each way. It was about 200, including the trip from England down to the ferry. So that was a much more relaxing way to do it. The only trouble with the ferry going to Bilbao is the timings are a little bit out. We had to arrive here Thursday afternoon. Just trying to think when it was, but yeah, it was Thursday afternoon. So what we've done, they've got some brilliant chalets. He's got 20 chalets on site, little wooden ones, and they're absolutely lovely. So we had two nights. We had a night on the ferry, and then we've had two nights in the wooden chalet, which was really nice. It was a nice break. So instead of breaking my neck and doing 1,000 mile drive down and having to do all this, we had a bit of a chill out and yeah, relaxing time really. It's been nice. But here we are, we're on the lake anyway, so business starts now. And yeah, like I say, the rods are ready to go, so I'm going to get them out now. It's only about an hour and a half of light left, so I'll do my best to find a few spots. I'm actually in the VIP swim. Not fished this swim before. Fished a few of the others, but not this one. But what this one has got is it's got loads of water. Loads of water. I didn't realise how much water this swim controls. The only thing I would say about that, a lot of it is quite deep water with, you know, sort of featureless. There is features out there, so that's what I'm going to look for. But yeah, it looks good actually. I'm pleased to be in here. It looks really nice. There's a few nice facilities which I'll show you as the session goes on, no doubt. But at the moment I need to get fishing basically, so that's what I'm going to do now, get the rods out. It's just the start. A nice session ahead of us, so hopefully it's going to be a good one. We'll see. Well, it is a nice evening. There's a few people on actually, considering it's, what have we got, December the 17th today. There's a couple of guys out there, a couple in swim 6, a couple in swim 9 and 10, a couple over in 5 as well, putting their rods out, so, but no problem, we've got loads of room here. So anyway, I've been told this tree here, I presume this comes up on a bar, I've been sort of told that 20 metres past that is a good area. I mean, I don't know this area at all, so yeah, I mean, it doesn't come up really shallow. It's 19 foot. I thought it might have come up a little bit more than that. Oh, it does there, saying that. Look, into 18. Using quite a heavy lead just to hold on these bars. You know, I mean, if you watched any of the videos, you will have seen this rig many times now. It is just the basic stuff with the fang twister, sort of knotless knotted with a KD style little key cray snowman. These are a bit different, just trying these out. The Nash BP12s, they're the bigger version of the BP range. Look quite nice so far. Anyway, this seems to be fairly uniform around here, so I will drop that down there. There we go. See what it feels like. Yeah, that's harder there. A little harder. Yeah, that's harder not plugging in there.
I'm gonna settle for that. That'll do actually. For now, until I find out what I'm doing better. I mean, start of the session, you know, people say to me, you know, what do you look for at the start of the session? Well, I try different things, you know, I don't really know half the time what I'm looking for. But I'll just look for something that takes me fancy or feels good. Not gonna go too mad with the bait. I'm gonna put a little bit out. These are all key cray. It's a key cray snowman, this one. And yeah, I suppose about 60, 70 baits just around the area. Not gonna bait them too tightly. I'm just hoping that fish are gonna come into this area and have a little mooch about. There we go. It's as simple as that at the moment. Like I say, I'm not 100% sure of what I'm doing. It's just a bit of trial and error, as is often the case at the start of the session, and then try and work things out. Something normally seems to work itself out, and they won't necessarily, if I do catch fish, come from these spots, but you know, that's fishing. Well, first morning. Hot night. Lovely sunrise. Sturgeon or something. It's fighting too hard for a carp.
I was hoping for at all on the first bite of an early morning, first day, but brilliant take. And one thing for sure, they do fight very hard, and I guess halfway through the fight that it wasn't a carp, but thought it was a bit late in the year for catfish, so I guess it might be one of these. I mean, they do go absolutely huge in here, up to about, well, 80 kilos is the record here, which I think is a French record. This one was only just over 30 pound, believe it or not. Give me a hell of a scrap anyway. There we go, first morning on the lake and we got a bite. Not quite what I was after, but some action anyway. Hopefully the next one will be a carp. Thank you. Well, we've got one. It's a little bit noisy as the gravel workings are in full swing on the lead up to Christmas, I suppose. Like I say, we've got one. It's the third morning, so three nights in. First morning we had that sturgeon. Not much happening in between, but a little change in the weather. It's quite cold, a bit drizzly, but well, just now it finally went off anyway, and not a big one, 25 pound mirror. Nice pretty fish though, and to be honest, just pleased to get one, really pleased to get off the mark. It's certainly not easy fishing. The weather hasn't been great. Been very still, and odd fish have been coming out though. So like I say, I'm pleased to get off the mark anyway, and a pretty fish as well, 25 pound. On the key cray, it was on the same spot as the sturgeon actually, and in about 19 foot there was a firmish spot that I found out there, just raises up slightly off the bottom, and yeah, just touching 19 foot, and not a load of bait around it because they're not feeding heavily, but well, we're off the mark, that's the main thing. So I don't think we're going to catch loads, but if I can just get a few, I'd be happy with that. You know, it's December, it's a cold session, even though it's the south of France, it's certainly not warm here. I think a high of about 7 degrees today, cold and miserable, but this one's cheered the day up anyway. So happy days, we've got one, we're off the mark.
Well, this might be interesting at some stage. This is a little pool just over the back of the lake by the outflow. If you look round there, there's the main lake and this is the outflow. And a couple of years ago they had a flood and the fish got out over this outflow, and they've since built this barrier to stop any more fish getting out, but some did get out anyway. And this little pool is blocked off more or less from the river. But I spoke to the guy the other day and he said, oh no, there's still two or three down in this little pool and it's only about a foot deep. Sure enough, I've looked today and I've seen three in there. I can actually see them now. You won't be able to see them from here. But there's a little mirror, a little common, and a bigger common. Not massive, but well, I put a little bit of sweet corn down there earlier and actually watched them feeding on it. So I'm just going down now, put a bit more sweet corn in, give them a few little citrus boilies, and who knows, might have a little dabble. I'm sure they feel like prisoners in this little pond, so it'd be nice for them to go back in the main lake, but I'm sure it's going to be trickier than what it appears to be, but we shall see. Well, they're all there again. All the bait I put out yesterday evening was all gone this morning, so I've put another half a tin of corn and some just spooked off a little bit there, some citrus boilies and a few key crays, and literally, well, the whole lot's gone. There's not a scrap left down there. Another mirror. I've noticed there's definitely four fish here, three together, but there's another mirror I spotted this morning and he's just over the other side there. Yeah, I might have to come and stick a rod out here soon. Look at him down here, hoovering up. It's all gone, mate. Your mates have eaten it all. I'll have to come back in a minute and put a bit more bait there. But he's looking for more. That's where it all was. Well, we're just going to have a quick couple of minutes. The fish are literally just the other side of that grass there. Just going to put two or three grains of corn on a size 8 uni. I mean, all the bait that I put out earlier is all gone. I've just thrown a couple more handfuls out. They've just moved out at the moment, so maybe it's the chance to get me bait in place. Maybe I'll sneak in and get the rig in place. I don't know if you can see him, but got one of the mirrors taking a couple of grains. He's actually closer in than where my hook bait is. That's two grains gone. Hoovering it up, he is. Yeah, very nice, mate. Tell you what, it's December the 21st. I bet there's not many people out stalking carp today, but I've actually stalked one on sweet corn in the edge. How about that? Brilliant.
Well, it's been the coldest day of the trip, but so far it's been the most eventful as well. We've just had dinner, settling down for the evening, and well, just about to put a film on actually. And one's rattled off, and it's one that I actually moved earlier on today. I've had one out in the middle on top of a plateau, and I had it in about 13, 14 foot. Nothing had happened anyway, so I moved it right down into deeper water, into about 20, 21 foot, and it was nice and hard down there. I thought, well, I'll try it, and well, it's only been there about five hours, something like that, and it's gone off with this one on the end, just under 38 pound, about 37.12. So a cracking surprise, and it just shows you getting the depth is always so crucial, especially on waters that have got a bit more depth to them, like this one. I mean, it's it's got quite an average depth of about 25 to 35 foot with lots of shallower bars, and sometimes they're up on the bars and sometimes they're down in deeper water, and at the moment it seems like they're in the deeper water. Like I say, this one come from about 21 foot, but yeah, happy days, things are starting to happen now, and hopefully it's going to carry on like that. But yeah, there we go, two fish today, so I'm well happy with that. Get this fella back and carry on with film night, I think. And now it's gone off twice in 12 hours, basically. I had a 37.12 yesterday evening, and then this morning this one, 32 pounds. Lovely hard fighting fish, but it just shows how little things make a difference, really. It'd been sitting up on that plateau, doing nothing, and I'm thinking there's not many fish about, where they were about, but they just didn't want to be up on the shallow water. Put it down a bit deeper and hey presto, off it goes. So, you know, well, it shows that it pays to try different things for a start, and it shows that, you know, the swim isn't always dead. You know, you think a rod is just sitting out there waiting for fish to come along, whereas if you do something different, you can make things happen. So, you know, I changed things up a little bit, and all of a sudden the dead rod has produced two fish in 12 hours, two nice 30s. So there you go. So the moral of the story is you don't always have to sit and wait, you can make things happen sometimes. I was lucky enough yesterday to be able to go around and see the latest stocking of fish going in the lake. Jeremy, the owner, he's been very proactive in stocking the lake over the years. And I was here when we was here 3 years ago at Christmas. He was sort of in the middle of a real big sort of stocking program at the time. And at that time, a lot of the fish actually went in this swim. We was fishing over in swim 6, so I came around and saw those fish, and yeah, luckily he had another stocking plan for this week. This time the fish were going in down the other end in swim 3, so I went down and saw those fish going in. He had about a ton of fish all together, something like that, to be split mainly between the two lakes, the front lake and this lake. I suppose there was something like about 100 fish went in this lake, and quality fish, actually, really good fish. You can see there those lovely sort of high backed sort of roundy shaped fish. The water quality is really nice here, but of course, you know, as much as the bait goes in here, and you know, that obviously helps, bait definitely helps fish grow, as it's proved on many lakes. Rainbow Lake, for instance, you know, the fish rocketed on there when more bait started going in, and I suppose over the years gradually more and more quality baits started to go in here, and that certainly helped. But you know, there's, to go along with that, it needs a fair amount of natural food as well, and on the face of it, you know, it's hard to see what that natural food is, certainly bloodworm and that. There's not much in the way of crayfish or mussels, but what there is, there's a lot of these, there's a type of shellfish in here. And the only other place I've seen these is down at Cassian, actually. So, you know, that bodes well for the lake, because we know how well Cassian's done over the years. And there we were talking about a fish the other day. Jeremy put one in here Well, he had his doubts whether he wanted to put it in, because it was a 16 kilo common, and he said, like, you know, he wasn't too sure on the look of it and really whether he wanted it in the lake, but he put it in anyway. And sure enough, that fish came out about 3 days ago at 27 kilos. A German guy had it in swim 10 at 27 kilos. So in 2 years, it's gone from 16 kilos up to 27 kilos. So that shows, you know, what the fish can, you know, sort of grow on, how well they can grow on in here. And they do, you know, there's countless other examples of fish that have grown on really well in here. Well, it's been a couple of days without a carp now. Not sure what the time is actually. It must be just coming up to Christmas Eve now. So, but apart from the massive great sturgeon I had the other night, 92 pound, this was on the same rod actually. It's been quiet carp wise, but I did go up and see the stocking of fish earlier on. And I thought maybe they might push the fish up this way, so you never know, it might have done that. So I've just had this one, which was 27.12, so not a big one, but certainly a welcome bit of action. And yeah, maybe it has done that, you know, because I know when they put the fish in this end, you know, last time I see a stocking 3 years ago, all the fish went in this swim actually, and what it did was push all the others right up the other end of the lake. So this time around, the stocking was at the far end, and the hope was that it was going to push the fish up this end. Well, this one was certainly up here anyway, so you never know, it might have done the trick. But, well, we've got one anyway, so pleased to see a fish. But not quite with it at the moment, just sort of woke up and screaming run, and straight out in the boat to play a fish. But we've got one anyway, so great stuff, back amongst the fish.
Well, it's Christmas Day and I haven't managed to catch one from the main lake yet. Did manage to lose one, got round a tree and I lost it, so I'm very disappointed about that. But in my attempt to catch a Christmas Day carp, I'm now back on the little back sluice pond, and I've been feeding these fish every day, and they've been mopping it up every day. A few key cray boilies and a bit of sweet corn. And, well, I fed them a bit early this morning and they've eaten all that. There was four carp here. I'm gonna get it out now because I can see the big common coming. That's where I need to be. Up there. Right. And all I'll do now is just crouch here and I mean they're all come in because they keep coming in and eating it all the time, so I've just got to be quiet and still and hope that he comes in and grabs that before the two little ones. There's two little small ones. There's a small mirror and a small common, and to be honest, the small ones would probably be all right in here, but the bigger one deserves to be in the main lake really. He's too big for this little pond, shallow pond. So well, I can see them just over there behind them branches. They're sort of heading this way. They will come in and have a look where the bait has been for sure, because they keep coming back here and they keep looking for the bait. So I'll be quiet for a minute. Oh, well, I got him. Oh, I don't believe it, but I finally got him. Christmas Day carp. Oh, stalking in the edge. Oh, look at that. He's a beauty as well. The little common in there. He tried to pick up my bait about 6 times. I had to pull it out of his mouth. And the big one looked spooky. But he kept swimming around and around and around. And eventually he came back and started having a few grains. And every time I went to switch the camera on, it sort of spooked him a bit, so I couldn't get it on film. Sure enough, he came back and I got him. Ah, Christmas Day carp stalked on free line sweet corn in the margins. Brilliant stuff. And from this little pool. But he can get, join his mates in the big lake now. Oh, happy days. Oh, I'm really pleased with that one. Oh.
Well, Christmas Day, and did get a Christmas Day carp after all. Not quite how I was expecting. I did lose one in the night out on the marks, which was very disappointing, but in the back pool, I've been feeding carp all week, and in particular, there was one decent common that I put about 25 pound that I was hoping to get, so I thought, well, today's the day to have a go for him. Sure enough, I went and caught him. Free line sweet corn in the edge. And well, it was all fireworks when it went off, obviously. Couldn't get it on film because every time I switched the camera on, it spooked him for some reason, so I left the camera off. He came back in, and I see him pick up the grains of sweet corn that were just in the edge, and a little bit bigger than what I thought. It was actually 27 and a half. But there we go. Christmas Day carp. That's all I wanted. I'd sort of had this as a backup plan. If I didn't catch one, I thought, well, I'm going to go and have a little bit of stalking on Christmas Day. Don't think I've ever been stalking on Christmas Day before, let alone actually caught one. But there we go. December stalking with sweet corn, and went and got one, and the biggest one in the pool as well. So there we go. I think he's going to be happier in the big lake somehow. So well, he may not be too happy at the moment, but he will be in a little while. But there we go. Happy days for me anyway, a Christmas Day carp. Well, finally broke through the 40 pound barrier anyway. Got 41 and a quarter. Whew. And well, actually it was the first take on this rod since we've been here. I've been messing about with a spot out there in 22 foot. It was a lovely hard spot. Looked and felt really good. But as until now, I just couldn't get a bite off it. But did something a little bit different yesterday evening. I put a couple of the old tangerine dreams on, and I've not used them for ages. They're the instant action range, came out with the coconut creams, and I thought I'd just try one of those in the deep waters. It's quite deep out there, 22 foot. I thought I'd try a couple of those on just for something different, really. A lot more flavour, a lot more attraction, and like they say, instant action. So that was the plan anyway, and lo and behold, it worked. First bite on that rod, and best one so far, 41 and a quarter. So probably try them on another rod as well today, just to see if it was a fluke, you know, a one-off, or if I've found something. But well, we got this one anyway, which was worth messing about with a few different things, you know, trying a few different things, You know, it paid off with this one, so happy days.
Well, I'm coming out to the central part of the lake here, and that yellow buoy in the middle marks, well, basically the centre of the lake from all points. So all of the swims round here, so you've got 5, 6, 7, me and 8, 9 and 10 can all basically fish up to that buoy. You know, everyone's water sort of goes to a point at that buoy. So I'm sure they'll all be watching me now, see if I'm taking liberties or not. Dunk. Yeah, I mean it is. It's lovely and hard there. I'm not going to put loads around it. Just literally putting that there. And the idea is higher track baits, hopefully get me a bite.
Well, at last we've got a good one. It's been a tough session this, really. I mean, I've caught fish, you know, sort of steadily all the way through, so I'm not complaining too much, but the big fish were conspicuous by their absence. But the last few days there's been a couple of better ones coming out, but from the other swims, so I thought, I hope I haven't missed my chance. And sure enough, I hadn't. This morning, just now, had this absolute great big beauty, 52-12. So, guys, amazing, they're so strong this time of year. Even after a good fight out in the boat, they're still strong. There we go. What an absolute beautiful fish, eh? Cool. And we're actually, I mean, we're getting near the end of the session now. We've only got a couple of nights left. So I was beginning to think the chance for a real good one, well, not quite gone, but it was getting that way. And so, you know, I'm so pleased to see this one. I mean, we've had some lovely fish anyway. This was from the spot out in the middle. I had a couple of fish from it earlier in the trip, and then it went dead. But I changed one rod over to Tangerine Dreams and caught a 40 the other day. So I changed this one to Tangerine Dream as well. Sure enough, it's what produced this one. So, well, there we go. You just never know. He fancies a bit of fruity stuff. So there we go. What a cracking fish, eh? What an absolutely lovely fish. Well, it's a freezing cold morning, probably the coldest morning we've had actually, but I've just had this one, and literally when I netted it, the net was frozen to the boat. I had some H blocks in there and they were all stuck to the net, so I had to unpeel everything before I could get the net in the water and defrost it. But I haven't weighed it. It's an upper 20, I don't know, maybe 30, but probably not, probably up a 20. But a nice fish. In its winter colours. And, well, more than welcome on a cold, frosty morning. Actually, the last day of the year. It's the last day of 2016, December the 31st. So, whatever happens. They're always the same, aren't they? God, as if you hadn't fought hard enough out in the boat. There we go. Last day of 2016. And finishing off with a carp. So that's nice, isn't it? Nice way. Well, that's another trip over. We're all packed up now. And just come back to the chalet for a while. Get things dried out. We've got the bivy covers and ground sheets that we're all soaking wet with frost, but they're all drying out here under the canopy. It's nice to get in the warm and have a shower. We've got about a day and a half before our ferry leaves, so it's actually nice just to come back here, get warmed up, have a nice meal, chill out a bit and get ourselves ready. It's only about 2.5 hours back to Bilbao, so it's not a great big journey we've got. Quite looking forward to the ferry drive home. But there were a couple of decent fish out. I went out around to the other side to Steph, who was in swim 5, and photographed, 27 kilos, so 60 pound mirror for him, cracking fish. And Volker in swim 4, German guy, nice German guy, he'd been struggling a bit. He'd had a few sturgeon, but hadn't had a carp, and then literally on the last morning, I put my phone on, and he'd had a 25 kilo mirror, 55 pounds, so fair play to him, you know, he stuck it out and persevered. And got his reward, a lovely fish. And I'll tell you what, the lake is really doing well at the moment. Iktus Lake is a fantastic place. And it's one of those lakes that's just on its way up. You know, he's put in a lot of fish a few years ago, Jeremy. And they're all really coming on in leaps and bounds now, putting on loads of weight. And there's a lot of 25 kilo fish out there now. So it's one of those waters to keep an eye on. And well, now's the time to get on it. Now in the next few years, it's really sort of going places. So I'm certainly going to be coming back here for sure. Besides the fish, it's just a lovely place to be. It really is a nice place, this. Nice people, great fish, and great facilities. But there we go. The fishing's over for me, so just these last few bits here. Get in the van and, like I say, have a little bit of a chill out, and then we'll be on our way back home. But it's been a great trip, so... Well, I hope you enjoyed the video and see you next time.